almost lost your life too?
Of course, I still had a lot of trauma. Arriving at the airport, all I could think of is, wow, I almost lost my life in this place. But everything changed when I stepped out of the airport and I saw Dr. Malinga, I saw DJ Ravi and the rest of the crew. I felt at home instantly, and from there everything was just okay.
After that incident, when you almost lost your life, did the government of South Africa come and maybe compensate you? Because you know, you're a public figure, Chikolerini Big was seen as South Africa. Was there any compensation? Was there any apology that came from the authorities?
No, I didn't expect one, and I wasn't hoping for one. I gave everybody that had to do anything with anything that happened to me in Tapoteng. I forgave them, I forgave myself. So after I did that, I had to move on. I didn't care about the government coming out. All I cared about was the people that love Lasso and they live in South Africa. And that's the people that I wanted to go back and do what I do for.
Okay, so in your time in South Africa, did you happen to visit the place that the incidents happened?
No, I didn't. Though I went to Soweto, one of the biggest ghettos in South Africa. Yeah. I went there and shot a video there. Nalonda Nemala, part of the video is shot in Soweto. So I went to other places like Limpopo, where Dr. Malinga comes from. I integrated with a lot of people that come from there that are, you know, real original South Africans. And I got to find out there is so many great people in South Africa, regardless of what happened to me. So I didn't go back there, but I got to feel the real heart of South Africa.
Okay, so the video is done, of course, the video of South Africa. You're boarding back to Kampala.
Yeah.
Maybe for you.